it's gone way right. He's blocked it. Oh no, it's on the green. Or just slightly short. Right, now watch how tall Karl stands when he chips. He stands with a very vertical club. He almost treats it like a putt. A little bit long, probably 5 feet past. He's got that for birdie. It's a birdie to open with. Good start. The par 3 fifth. Green slopes left to right. Pins at the back of the green. Don't want to really take the pin on because if you go past the back, you never get up and down for par. See, good eye follow through. Good shot. Slightly to the right of the flag. Yep, it's a good spot to have a two-putt par there. Carl's had a good tee shot. He's put it directly under the hole, about 15 feet. Good chance, good opportunity to attack this putt. Oh, I need one more roll. So one after two holes. Right, Carl's gonna use a 3-wood on this dog leg left. Should be starting out to the right, let it draw back. It's holding its line, but that'll be fine. It didn't draw, but the reason he didn't use a driver is if it held its line like that with a driver, it would have been through the end of the fairway. And the challenge on a day like this for the players, see, they don't have a caddy that can be holding the umbrella and sort things out. They're juggling to try and keep their clubs and grips dry, but they're also trying to keep their towels dry, which is impossible. Without either having a push cart or a caddy, but there's no push carts allowed in this tournament and no caddies allowed, so boys generally end up juggling everything around like a circus clown. So a good drive, he split the middle of the fairway with his 3-wood. He could have used driver, but then he risks running through the fairway here. So he's only about 140 out. Probably going to be using a 9-iron, maybe an 8-iron, but most likely a 9-iron. Okay, Carl's ready to go. Big high follow through. Sounds a bit skinny. The other players are happy with it though. But it was a little bit skinny. It's a good shot there by Carl. He's Again, he's left himself under the hole. His goal at the start of the round was to make sure that at all costs he doesn't go past the hole with his approach shots, because he doesn't want to be left with downhill putts. Right, Chief, let's get this birdie putt to the hole. Left the last putt agonisingly short.
Does he have any idea of any dream schools he wants to play golf?
Yeah, he wants Oklahoma.
Really?
Yeah. Cool,
nice
birdie.
Putt.
There you go. That's what we're talking about. Likes that. Let's see how it goes. He's on the right side of the pin. Is he on the green? No, he's actually missed the green right. Karl's ball didn't quite hold the green, so he's only a couple of yards off it. It's not a bad miss though. Missed it. Swing at it a bit hard. You don't need to bash those into the hole. From a foot away, yes, bash it in, but when you're 5 foot, you don't bash it. Just feed it into the hole. So it's going to be a bogey, so it's going to give one of those shots back. But he's got it that downhill putt quite hard, and it's not a gimme coming back. Okay, Karl to tidy up for a bogey. It's a shame to give a shot back. His pin was on the right side of the green, so he should never have missed right. Always go to the heart of the green with your tee shot. Yes, it's just those really good work with the two birdies. It's just been, or one of the birdies has been given back. All right, after giving one of his birdies back on the last hole, very careful what side of the green you miss, and he missed on the wrong side of the green on the last hole, so wasn't able to get up and down. He's lost his grip there. I mean, the drive's gone like a rocket. It's probably in A1 position, but you can see his grip slip there. Just this constant drizzle is starting to take its toll. Right, Karl's left himself. The actual drive, he was lucky. He's right dead set in the centre of the fairway and hit him an absolute mile. But he's very lucky because his grip slipped on his swing. So he sort of got away with one there. But he's left himself with about 90 yards uphill. So he's going to play it as if it was a 100-yard shot. Can't go past the flag here. Good birdie. So go back to 200, that's three birdies in his first six holes. Or five holes. All about having your hands full. Juggling the umbrella, the bags, the towels. The joys of playing in rain without a caddy or a pushcart. Karl's 2 under after the first 5 holes with 3 birdies and a bogey. Right, got to keep this to the right of the flag. Par 3 must give it to the right of the flag. It's the right side of the flag. He's not happy with it, but as long as it's right, that's perfect. That gives him an uphill putt. Couldn't be better. Well, In the hole would be better, but that's ideal. It's a cold day, it's wet and it's grey, and you're not going to play perfect on a day like this.
Carl's got a good looking birdie here. Should be pretty much dead straight. If anything, there's a hint of left to right, but I'd be starting it inside the left half of the cup.
Oh, he got put off by the other boy's putt that went 5 feet past. It's one of those things where you watch somebody else's putt that races past and you think, well, maybe it's a bit faster than I think. So he was a little bit cautious with it, but he's left that one right in the jaws, a couple of inches short. Well, we start the next nine, but they've only played 6 holes of the front nine. They've got to finish off the other 3 after this nine. Happy with that. Thing with Karl, so much like players like Sergio, you know exactly what's happened with the shot without even having to look where the ball went. Ooh, actually, that's good. He's very lucky. He only hit it at about 80%, so by hitting it 80%, he hasn't generated spin on the ball, so it didn't spin back off. But that's actually a really good place, because he can putt aggressively at the hole. How can that stop? His putting has been excellent, but his couple of them just haven't dropped. He must get it to the hole. Carl's first drive was pulled left out of bounds, so he's had to re-tee it on the first, and this is where his third shot ended up. Got to get these big misses out of your game. Doesn't like that. Makes it very hard. Now that's most probably going to be a two-putt, but it makes it very hard to shoot really low numbers if, you know, Karl has his 6 birdies around, but he gives at least 6 shots back in bogeys, double bogeys. Carl's putting for a bogey. Good effort. Right. Par 3, I don't know, 11th I think, or 12th. Very narrow green to shoot at. Carl's just on the last hole, hit his drive OB, so he took a double. But, got to reset, go back to normal now. Let's see how it goes here. Oh, hang on. But golf is a game where getting greedy can be the difference between winning and not winning major tournaments. You can't always go at the flag.
Good shot.
right, Karl should be starting this up the lift. So Theo's going to kick left to right. Perfect. It is absolutely perfect. It's going to fly over the crest and then just kick right. Right, Karl's ball sitting on a slide up slope. Well, that's not a good shot. That was left all the way. Right, Karl won't be very happy with his approach shot there, because by hitting it left a bit, it's also gone long. And this is a severe downslope that he's putting onto here. He's got to just nurse this down to the hole. Lag it down. About as hard as you wanted to hit it. Good, oh, good birdie.
Wonderful putt.
Oh, good birdie by Karl there on the last hole. Very good putt. Happy with that. Karl split the fairway with his drive. It's a really good one and very long. Okay. Karl's probably only about 60 to 70, probably 70 yards out. Looks good. Oh, nearly hit the flag. Good shot. Stepped with about 5 feet there. Can't first break, but gotta be gentle with it. Bit of right to left break. Oh, mate, a little more right to left than that. You'll be lucky to get your par now. Come on. The most important facet of a downhill putt is the speed. Work out the speed first and then figure out the break that it's going to require. Well, that's just the most stupid three-putt I've ever seen in my life. You actually pulled that. You shut your club face on that last putt. That's a bogey after being 3 feet away for a birdie. Karl split the middle with his drive on the second hole, par four. Gave himself another good shot at birdie there. But Karl with another birdie opportunity on the second hole. Probably got about 10 feet. Got it.
Good putt.
I thought he'd missed it there for a minute. So all that anger's gone. Karl's had two straight bogeys. I mean, two straight birdies. It's the last hole for the day. It's the third hole on the front nine. Right, you can see the flag there between the two trees. The car doesn't have a shot. Just knock it out sideways. You'll only be left with 100 yards. You can still walk off with par if you can one putt, but at the worst you'll walk off with is bogey. Don't bring a bigger score into play. God, he's put her on the green. That's a great shot. Gutsy. Gutsy indeed. That's his ball right there in the middle of the frame. Karl's a long way from the hole, but he is putting for birdie. Oh, straight over the hole. That's a bogey out of it. Get too aggressive with it, Chief. Don't get aggressive.